Hello everyone and welcome to this video. In this video we are going to talk about PCV system. So due to high pressure of combustion inside the cylinder, some of the unburned fuel and other products of combustion leak past the piston rings and move into the crankcase. So this phenomena is known as blowby, and as mentioned, these are unburned fuel, and these are hydrocarbons. So these hydrocarbons and other products are being recirculated by PCV system, and if the blowby is not removed, it will condense inside the crankcase, and not only that, it may react to engine oil to form a sludge here. So this newly born sludge will definitely corrode the engine and piston rings and bearings and valves, etc. So the unburned fuel will dilute the lubrication oil also, and the dilution of lubrication oil will lower the viscosity of the oil and will create lubrication problem also. So also the presence of blowby gases increase the pressure inside the crankcase. It can break seals and can come out leaving a leakage in the crankcase. So now let's see how it works. So there are many types of engines, so their PCV system arrangement varies also, and but apart from various components used, they are for the same work. So a PCV system uses engine vacuum to withdraw air into the crankcase, and the intake manifold is connected with PCV valve via a hose, and other side of the PCV valve is connected to the crankcase so that it can allow fresh air and blowby gases to flow through the this passage. So the blowby gases generally comes through the passage made in cylinder head, and this is the simplest diagram that can be drawn to understand the PCV system. So here in this figure it is shown that this is directly connected to the crankcase. So when blowby gases along with air comes to PCV valve, the vacuum created by intake stroke opens a tapered valve which is inside the PCV valve, and this opening makes the air and blowby gases to go into the intake manifold, and hence these gases are ignited for power stroke. But the PCV valve controls the flow of blowby gases. It allows the blowby gas only to flow when there is a low manifold vacuum, and restricts blowby at high vacuum in the manifold. So that's how it works. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.